In this lesson, we will cover the local business add-ons. Let's start to explore the loyalty card add-on. To build a loyalty program inside your app, you need to follow a three-step process. Number one, we need to set up the loyalty card. A card is composed by a number of units people need to obtain in order to have a gift. Give a friendly name to your units so that people can understand what they need to collect. And define the number of points in your card. You have the option to define an average value for a unit. If you do so, in the stats menu, you'll be able to measure the impact of the loyalty program on your business. Choose a design for your loyalty card and customize it. Several options are available. You can browse them in the app menu. Let me show you some examples of what you can obtain. Step number two, the validation process. You need to define how people will collect points. You can only choose one rule. First one, purchase. People will scan with their app a QR code you present to them. Second one, check-in. Within a given area, people will be able to check inside their app to get a point. Third one, social media sharing. Define a URL people will share within your app to be able to get a point. Step number three, the gift. Define here what you're going to offer. You have a lot of design options. Let me show you some examples. The backend is set up now and I have downloaded the QR code. Let's see what happens in app. Let's go to the loyalty card section of my app. Okay, and now I have a gift and I can see it in the list of my gifts. And I can decide to redeem it when I want before the expiration date. In my example, we have completed one loyalty card and it has been reset to zero to start a new one. We are going to see now how you can value people who complete more than one loyalty card. And this is when the club card add-on comes into play. Let's go back to the add-on store and add the loyalty card add-on. You cannot use the club card add-on without the loyalty card add-on. A new section appears under the cards menu. And this is the place where I'm going to set up my three cards. So there are three levels you can define to give exclusive privileges to very loyal users. Start to define the number of points people will have to collect to gain the status of a silver member. You can also edit the name of the first stage of this card. Then define the privilege and design your club card. Now, when people go to their profile in the app, they will see a My Card menu. And if they belong to one level, they will see the card and also the number of points they need to collect to reach the next level. So people can collect points on their loyalty card, and if they reach a certain level, they can become a member with the club cards. Let me show you now another way to reward people outside the loyalty card program. Under the Reward menu, you can send rewards to your users based on predefined scenarios. The welcome reward is sent to every new user that logs into your app for the first time. With the Happy Hour reward, you can send an automatic reward for certain days and time of the week. The check-in reward is received by people when they cross a predefined zone that acts as a geofence. When activated, the welcome back reward will be received by people who have not used your app for a certain time. You can also send rewards outside those automatic rules, and this is what's called a one-time reward. Define your gift and design it. You can then send it to all the active users of your app. The manual tab will give you the history of the one-time reward you have sent and also the stats associated to each of them.
let me show you now a last trick to send a reward to a specific person using your app.
Go to clients list to see the active users of your loyalty program. If you edit one profile, you'll be able to switch the person to another level of the club card. You can also set up the number of points on the currently active loyalty card, and you can also modify the total number of points collected by these users. From the list, you can select one or several users and send them a reward. Let's have a look now at the couponing add-on. When activated, the couponing add-on will create a section inside the app where you can display offers. When you create a coupon, give it a name, additional information, and choose the validation process. If you choose the redeem button, it means that coupons will be managed inside your app. If you choose the promo code, it means that this coupon is managed outside the app. The app is just a way to display the coupons. When managed by the app, several options are available. In terms of date, you can choose the starting and the ending date for the coupons, and also you can decide how many times the offer will be available, whether it is at the global level inside the app or per user. Use categories to organize coupons inside the app. If you do so, you will have extended functionalities in the design menus. You can set up a background image and also store information where the store is located so that people can redeem the offer. If you set up this value inside the app, the distance between the user and the shop will be displayed inside the coupon.
I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time, and meanwhile, happy building.